Good morning and welcome. What's the problem with being awake? My name's Ben, I'll be your host, and today I want to talk about the corruption inside of NATO and how people have profited from wars. Our people and other countries' leaders, our free leaders of the world, have profited from the wars abroad, and bring that to light, our stabilization of the world as it is. And I must say, you know, congratulations to President Donald Trump. He was the only choice if he didn't want the world to get worse. So if you were of the Kamala Harris persuasion, I'm sorry, but everything pointed towards the world getting worse, and she had no experience to justify it. He can keep the world contained. People might not like his personality, but they will like his actions. And that's what matters. He does deliver good. And he delivers well. He delivered the Abraham Accords. If his name wasn't Donald Trump, he'd have got a Nobel Peace Prize for making that happen. 60 years they've tried, and he managed to do it in two. And that was due to be signed just after October 7th, within a week of October 7th. It was due to be signed between Saudi Arabia and Israel, making peace within the region complete. And then October 7th couldn't allow that to happen because the Iranians need a build population of terrorists in those areas, you know, so they had to make sure that Saudi Arabia couldn't make peace with Israel. And in the end, Saudi Arabia under Biden and Harris ended up making diplomatic negotiations open again for the first time in 25 years since the Ayatollah came. So that's big. Our four enemies. We were closer to World War III than we have been, even including the Cuban Missile Crisis. Almost every military expert I've heard, and that's, let's say, 15 who I respect, and some British, some mostly American military experts, have seen the warning signs for the war in Russia turning into World War III, the war in the Middle East turning into World War III in China, forcing the issue of World War III. So we don't have that now. So let's move on to NATO. I'm an English American, but I'm English born, English passed. NATO. There's a big scam which happens when a load of missiles or load of ammunitions or basically a payload of war materials. When those contracts are given, there are people inside of NATO and inside of whichever company is giving them that know that that company's stock is going to go up the day before. And there's been multiple cases in America, Republicans and Democrats alike, of them placing big money in buying shares in a company, which then triples in size the next day. And there have been many members of the EU who have done the same thing. So war to them is about money. It is an industrial complex, a military complex, as I said. But, you know, that's insider trading in a political way, and it's completely abhorrent. But it's fragile by law to get it proven. What I do also want to say about NATO is I agree and have always agreed entirely with the Donald Trump's viewpoint that everybody has to pay their fair share. And if they don't, ultimately, they don't get the US military umbrella. Now, one of Britain's top generals, and bear in mind, we're the only country that pays what we're supposed to pay, and we also have the best backup military. We've got the Trident submarine missiles, and our force is absolutely outstanding. So our air support is great. What we don't have is, and he said, the whole of Europe don't have, we don't have defensive technologies that we need. So we can offend. We've got the Trident missile system, so those are some of the biggest bombs in the world. They could take out in Russia one bomb. Not that I want that. That's obviously the worst case scenario, but they're built for that. But the other, we're the only NATO nation who pays what every NATO nation agreed to pay. So when Trump gets back in, pay your bills because you agreed them. It's not like it was Trump who said, unless you pay 2%, I'm not going to provide support. It was an agreed upon deal, and every country has welched on it except for England. And I encourage anyone from any other country to push this issue with their government, because if they continue to welch on it, they will find themselves without report and without support. And NATO will find it very difficult to support anything without US support, because the US pay for over 95% of all Western world military defenses every year. They spend trillions. They spend more than our government's national budget on defending all of us from just making sure that we're all defendable. And what, we can't spare some cash to help him out? He's asking for 2% of GDP. And if you're gross deficit profit, so profit after deficit, so defense funding, 2%. So it's a very small number. Every country can manage it. Every country, to say they can't, because everyone's in the same boat with financial struggles and struggles in the market and inflation and things like that. But to say that they can't do it is an absolute lie. They don't want to do it, and they want US to pay for it. And that, I think, is absolutely a warped view of the world that they have. And I urge the leaders of the NATO countries to ensure that that 2% is the first conference that you have about making sure that the US get paid what you agreed to pay them. Otherwise, you're just hot air. Anyway, I'll leave this video here. I would like England to contribute more, but not before others get back up to speed and get to their fair share. You've been lucky, I'll be good, and I'll see you soon.